Buddha ruin. There are many, many Buddha lamps. But Sakyamuni Buddha only told of a few, like the Amitabha Buddha land and the Medicine Buddha land, yeah, except some of the heavens, smaller heavens. By the way, he told a story that he was in heaven, but not much was described. And many of his disciples went to some heavens also, came back and didn't describe much. Maybe sometimes all the people there are giant, giant, you know, when we get there, we will just be like a fly compared to them. Something like that only, but cannot describe too many because no vocabulary in this world can describe them. Yeah, that is in the shadow world even. Yes, not to talk about beyond that. Even beyond the fifth level, we can't describe already. Even at the fifth level, four level, can't describe already. Just I told you some, you know some, during the time of initiation up to the fifth level, but nothing more.
Yes.
Why have I told you this? What was it before?
You said you already told us everything, Master.
Oh, yeah. I told you everything as much as your earthly instrument can understand. The brain can understand. Everything else, higher than that, is the mind. The mind, intelligence. Higher than that is just the soul's domain. And only the soul will be able to understand such. Yes. Even if I want to know many more things from the higher one and to convey to this world, I have to rely on different levels to give me the resume and show it to me, translate it into worldly sense. Yeah. My soul, my higher self knows everything, of course. But if I want to check it compared to the worldly things, I have to use a different instrument for myself or using different gods and deities to tell me.
Yes.
The higher you go, the more difficult. Almost like you know nothing anymore. Nothing. I just know sometimes and tell you something or tell the world something only when necessary. Okay? And then I have to get the information. Otherwise, we know nothing. And that's good so. Because if you know too much, you don't want to live here.
It's true.
Yeah. The people who die clinically for just some minutes. Remember the story of near-death experiences?
Yes.
Yeah. They came back to Earth. They did not want to. They were forced to come back because they still had work to do for karma or for helping the world. They cry off and on for weeks or months. Yeah. And always longing to go back. Doing things in this world just half-heartedly. And that is just astral level heaven or heavens. Imagine if you want to go higher up, even fourth level, fifth level, even third level, second level, you don't want to come back already. Not to talk about higher ones, okay? You have no more brain, no more mind, no more thinking in such a way as we are thinking here on this planet. You understand what I'm saying? Yes, man. You can't even think anymore the way people think here. You don't act the way people act here. It's a completely different story altogether. Just like somebody somewhere in the jungle for a long, long time, they never see other countries, you know, or any other places apart from their own little area in the jungle, yes? And nobody ever came there. Recently, they discovered some tribes inside the Amazon jungle. But still, many still are not discovered. They had never known what other humans look like. And they react the way they react. They do things the way they do. They live just under the thatch roof with some poles that they cut from the trees. Then they grow some vegetables or cassava in some areas, yeah, to eat them. And when that cassava finished, they go to the other area where they planted before. They take turns to plant in different places so that they can rotate to eat. So that's all they do.
Yes, Master.
They have to live somewhere near water, yes, and have some easy to clear area to plant their food. And that's what they do, okay? But if they go to Paris, for example, after a while, they will not remember They will not do the way they did over there in the jungle anymore, okay? They will not go to find the clearance to plant cassava. There are no medicinal plants and no fruit trees that grow around these Paris coffee shops or bakeries or supermarkets. They don't walk anymore, they drive. And the water runs out from the wall, the tap water, yes. And the light just comes out without the sun even, at night or so. They will not do the things they did. They will not light the fire in the middle of their thatch roof, yeah, to keep warm. They will wear clothes. They will not go around unclothed like the way they did before.
Yes, ma'am.
So they're two different worlds completely. Therefore, it's very difficult. If somebody from Paris came to tell the Amazon dwellers that, in our world, the water comes from the wall, okay? Or comes from the long pipe like that. They don't even know what a wall is. They don't have walls in some of the tribes in the Amazon. They just have a roof on top, okay? And they weave some hammock to hang themselves there to sleep. Yeah, and they don't wear clothes. They do not have clothes. In many of the documentary films I saw, they don't have clothes. Okay? They just live naturally. It's just habit. They don't feel that cold like we do. Many yogis in India, they don't wear clothes. They get used to that. Or they use ash to smear on their body to keep warm. And there was one story about one priest, a Christian father who went to South or Central America before, you know, before long, some hundred years ago, yes, before we had the so-called American country, the United States of America, before we had that. He went there with some boat or ship or something before and then went there and somehow got lost. And then luckily the native people at that time, they rescued him. His ship was lost or something. No matter what, he went and lived with the native tribes, yeah? And there they treated him well. They gave him everything that they had also, you know, corns and cereals and water, everything, except clothing, because they did not have clothes. They were natives, maybe the native Indians at that time. So he just lived like that. After a while, his clothes were gone, you know, tattered. Or he probably didn't have any more after the shipwreck. I can't remember. It doesn't matter. After a while, he could not have any more clothes. That's the conclusion. He didn't have any. And then he got so used to it that when he was rescued by his country, there was a Spanish priest, and then brought back, he wrote many letters saying how civilized the native people are, how loving and kind, you know, and generous. So please don't harass them, don't kill them, don't things like that. I think I have it. I read the story for you, no? Maybe. Oh, I forgot now. Too many stories I read, thank you to you. I mean, to you and your brothers and sisters. Too many in my head. Imagine, at my age, I still remember so much. It's already very lucky, no?
Yes.
And after that, he came back to a so-called civilized area with the Spanish, maybe governor or some high official, something like that. And they gave him clothes to wear. In the beginning, he could not. Yeah, he could not bear the touch of the cloth on his skin. After a long while, then he could wear them, because he has to. Imagine if I say, it's all illusion, I don't need, I just wear nothing and go out there, and what will the police do? Okay, now, so that probably answers all your questions, yeah? I don't know why I talk so long afterward. Tell me why.
Because you said you cannot explain the things from the higher worlds.
Yeah. Because we cannot describe, yes, the things that we had never know. Just like the Amazon people, they never saw people. And they don't know clothes, okay? The real Amazon dwellers, some very remote tribe. I don't know how they found them after a while. But they didn't do anything to them. They treated them well. They are more civilized than many of our people. Sadly, it's like that. They treat them well. They give them food and all that. And they let them film them. I saw several documentary films. Yeah. Okay, my love. I still have a lot of documents to check out. And you too, huh?
Mm. Yes, master.
So long, eh? Next time.
Thank you.
Love you. On the cheek, okay, and remote, yeah? Please don't tell newspaper people. And not on the cheek, actually, normally if I kiss the disciple, I kiss here, okay?
Yes, master.
On the forehead, to remind them of the wisdom eye. Yes, but I don't kiss anymore because I read so many of these stories from New York, okay? It's better be safe than sorry.
Yes.
You never know what people think and what they do with that picture. Ay, ay, ay. If people sue me like that, will you still believe me?
Always.
We always believe you, Master. Yes.
I hope so. Please. Okay, huh?
Yes.
All right. Mostly people don't sue women, eh? Maybe that's why I take up the woman's body this time. But I still have a lot of typhoons and storms during my spiritual mission. You all know, right?
Yes.
And many that I don't tell you, and many that we don't know even. Huh? Okay? Yes. All right. My love, God bless you.
Thank you, Master.
Thank you, Master. Good night, Master.
Love you, Master.
Love you too, and please meditate well whenever you can.
Yes, Master.
Yes, Master. Yeah.
Of course, and when you're tired, you must also rest. Yes, I really love you and admire you because you work day and night, 24/7. Most of us are like that. I rarely have time to do. We have a break sometimes, of course, you know, to drink a coffee to stay awake or have some meal, but nothing much. Huh? You want to go on holiday? No. Nice, huh? No. You cannot. The world needs you. And it's a pandemic. Got that?
Yes,
Master.
Okay. Take care.
Okay.
Take care, Master.
A lot of love.
Love you, Master.
Really. And thank you.
Thank you, Master.